and gentlemen, strap yourselves down, because if you don't know anime, you have no idea what you're in for. You're going to see ninjas, Lolitas, magical girls, demons, and of course, cat girls to name a few, at the March Toronto Anime Convention. Now, keep an open mind as we cover this two-day convention in the heart of Toronto.
I'm a keeper of the modern society.
Started, you should know at least two things. One is cosplay, which is the Japanese short term for costume, and play, which is where someone dresses up as their favorite anime, video game, or movie character. Now, another term is crossplay, where it's the same idea except as a character of the opposite sex. Most cosplayers start a costume months in advance and spend countless hours working out every detail, unless they're crazy enough to start one only days before, which usually involves countless days of no sleep. And there's always eBay for the more uncreative types. As usual, our costume was being finished moments before we had to head to the Metro Toronto Convention Center. The best thing this year about this con was that it was free. Free! Nothing is better for a starving student who spends all their food money on costume supplies. One of the highlights of the convention is seeing friends you only get to see at these events. The first order of business on Saturday was the Naruto photo shoot that was organized on the forums of cosplay.com. This is where painstaking hours of sewing a costume really pay off. Everyone gets a chance to pose for the camera, but of course, the main characters always get the limelight. Someone even brought music to the shoot this time, and unfortunately there always happens to be a couple yaoi shots thrown into the mix. Yaoi is male-male relationships that are often graphic, and these have become a lot more popular recently.
Wow, we're learning things today.
After an hour or two of the photo shoot, we moved on to a massive lineup to meet voice actors Laura Bailey, Colleen Clickenbird,
you know you're useless in the ready,
Jason Liebricht,
snake bites,
and Chris Sabat.
Well, that's great.
And of course, a convention wouldn't be a convention without a deal room full of merchandise to buy. Enough manga, posters, plushies, and DVDs to empty any fan's wallet, and more chances to stop cosplayers for pictures. It was back to the voice actors for an entertaining interview with Chris Sabat and Jason Liebricht.
Actually, a lot of people said they liked the dub of a Fruits Basket more, rather than the translation. And really, in some cases with the show that is so rapid fire as Fruits Basket, sometimes better to have English happening because otherwise it's too hard to read everything that's going on.
Yes, you may be right.
You don't have to agree so easily.
But we can't give up. A journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. Try hard enough and nothing is impossible.
I don't hate World of Warcraft. I am afraid of the power of World of Warcraft. I got into playing EverQuest because actually Laura Bailey was a huge EverQuest fan. And she said, Chris, you gotta play EverQuest. And
she would like that. Man.
My roommate walked in one time where my character's just sitting on the ground waiting for Laura's character to come back from somewhere. He's like, dude, that is the most pathetic thing I've ever seen.
I kind of prefer to work without much advanced knowledge of what I'm going to be doing. Because I like for my interpretation to be honest.
You know, you should become a novelist with the stories you tell.
Then on to another line to get a good seat for Cosplay Idol, the last and most interesting event of the day, where cosplayers perform skits and are judged by the voice actors to determine a winner. It was hosted by Colleen.
She will even risk headlines.
If you have lies, I'm soon.
And Chris acted like Simon from American Idol, which was absolutely hilarious.
The skit made me laugh in sort of a painful I'm having a baby kind of way.
The best skit, without a doubt, was renowned Johnny for his skit as Cid from Final Fantasy VII.
How'd you like it if you were like in line for an ATM at the grocery stores, going through your everyday business, and suddenly, boom, monster! You're fighting a life and death battle, you know, for some unknown reason, doing grocery shopping or getting some money, boom, unknown battle! And it doesn't make sense. No orcs, no dragons, no goblins. It's stuff you find in your backyard, like rats, rabbits, and caterpillars. I can go on the phone, talk to my gardener, Bob, and boom, all my garden problems. problems are gone. But no, I have to use this thing and wipe out an ant colony 1 by 1.
Now it's time to go home to recuperate for another early start the next day. The last day of a convention is always left for side events, like Wheel of Anime. This is where you try and guess a character from an image, and other things such as watching movies and episodes of anime in theaters, which, unfortunately, cameras aren't allowed. There was another voice actor Q&A this time with Colleen and Laura.
I know, it's adorable, but FaceTime. And I don't get to play, like, hot characters very often, you know? Like, I mean, Lust. Come on.
But, like, how often does
that happen?
That's, like, one trope.
Elf.
Yeah, Elf.
Are you serious?
She Princess of Power.
Yeah, hello.
That would be my choice.
The scariest moment of the con was coming around a corner to come face to face with one of the conventioneers. They're now well known in the anime scene due to the one mean guy that beat up a kid on camera at Anime North 2006. After warning fellow cosplayers of their presence, we went outside to escape their radar and get food. The cheapest and quickest form of food is the fry wagon. Going out in costume always gets the most amusing reactions. Back inside, we came across some girls trying to burn some energy. When you get hyper anime fans who don't want to go home or sit still reading manga, you find them doing crazy stuff like sliding down the middle of escalators. And as much as we didn't want to go home, all good things must come to an end. So with empty wallets, full cameras, and weary bodies, we all headed back out into reality and already anticipating the next anime gathering.
I don't know, what does a bag question?
It says Department of Corrections.
It says,
Oh, it actually does say that?
What does it say?
It says House of Corrections.
I was totally just joking.
Did he say rape or reap?
Anyway, I'm not gonna cry or anything. I'm not Vic. Oh no, I'm just joking. I'm just joking. Listen, don't put that on YouTube. Do not put that on YouTube. Do not. I like him. I love Vic. Vic is awesome.
They can cut that part out, you know.
And don't put that part on either. I like him. I like him alright. It's okay.
Well, there's room for improvement.
He's writing your name in the death pool.
Alright, let's hear the whole question.
Windfall! Art thou will rank the award of Chris and Jason's cell phone in your Yu Hakusho show. And to conclude our show, Colleen Klinkenbeer will be singing the theme to Titanic.
As soon as everybody leaves.
God is watching us.
Wait, that's not it.
You'll be singing, and Jason Avery will be singing the theme to Beaches.
Is that what that is?
I have no idea.
You guys have been lovely! Back on!